Hey, brothers and sisters, this is Brother Patrick. I wanted to make, the Lord's been dropping wisdom on me today, even though we had 5 hours of brownout today, power outage today. Praise God, the power's back on, and praise God, God's just been dropping, the Lord's been dropping words on me, brothers and sisters, at a depth. It's unbelievable. The Lord showed me a new text about the rapture, proof of the rapture. I've never seen this text before. You know, it's always there, brothers and sisters. You know, God makes it click. Those of you who get words from the Word, you hear from God, it's like something in the Bible. It's been there all along until God would open your eyes, brothers and sisters. As an example, I always mention water baptism. You know, in the Bible, they translated that word baptismo directly. You know, they didn't make a change to it and say submersion in water. They just kept calling it that word. So that's why through the dark ages and all that, when the Word of God was hidden from the people, they began to, you know, sprinkle water over people's heads and all this other stuff. And then one day, you know, God has been restoring His churches since the time of Martin Luther, one step at a time, which I've made many, many videos about that, brothers and sisters. But if you go look at church history, you'll see since the time of the Reformation, God has been restoring the church step by step. One of those steps was finally, you know, one day someone was reading the Bible and said, wow, it says when Jesus came up out of the water, when he was baptized, the Spirit of the Lord descended on him like a dove. Then it says in another text that Paul wrote that we're buried with Christ and resurrected with him in water baptism. So to be buried like under the ground, you have to be submerged. Jesus went down under the water and came back up in his baptism. You know, God, that word was always there, brothers and sisters. And then God turned on the light and restored that part back to the church, just like he has done the gifts of the Spirit since 1907 with the Pentecostal movement, etc. So this is really weird, brothers and sisters. I want to show you something. I'm not usually one of these type of people, but when I was getting ready to start this video, look, I got these, I don't think you guys can see them. There's these, I got like several different feathers. It's just, when I was getting ready to start making the video, there was some feathers that fell here. I don't know. All in my face. Several different feathers. Several different ones. I don't know. You know, I'm not one of those people, you know, who look for those kind of things. But, I mean, I look for God to do anything. I don't seek out those things specifically. I do pray for God to do miracle signs and wonders in all ways, brothers and sisters. Well, praise God. I don't know where they came from, but God knows the explanation. Anyway, so this is something the Lord showed me about the rapture. 1 Corinthians chapter 15. Let's start. I just want to start reading with verse 22. 1 Corinthians chapter 15. For as in Adam all died, even so in Christ shall all be made alive. But every man in his own order, Christ the first fruits, afterward they that are Christ at his coming. Okay, some people think it's the second coming. No, it's the rapture. Listen to this. Verse 23. And all this ends up, he's talking about the rapture of the church anyway, the resurrection of the dead. 1 Corinthians 15, go read the whole chapter, it's resurrection of the dead. The other message I have to get is, I'm going to use the same, further on in the same chapter. Verse 1 Corinthians 15:23. But every man in his own order, Christ the first fruits, afterwards they that are Christ at his coming. Verse 24, then cometh the end, when he shall have delivered up the kingdom to God, even the Father, when he shall put down all rule and authority and power. For he must reign till he hath put all of his enemies under his feet. For that last enemy that shall be destroyed is death. See, now listen to this. Like I said, verse 23, for every man in his own order, Christ the first fruits, when Jesus resurrected, afterward they that are Christ at his coming. That's not the second coming. That is the rapture, the glorious appearing, the harposa, the glorious appearing of the Lord for his church. Then cometh the end when he shall, and it's not at the end of the millennial reign. Listen to what it says. Then cometh the end when he shall have delivered up the kingdom to God, even the Father, when he shall have put down all rule and all authority and all power. So Jesus is going to come put an end to the kingdom of Antichrist and put down all rule and power of the world. The Antichrist kingdom and evil and sin and all that. Verse 26, the last, and verse 25. For he must reign till he hath put all enemies under his feet. The last enemy that shall be destroyed is death. That's it, brothers and sisters. Another textual reference to the rapture that I've never seen before. I've never seen anybody teach on that. Maybe they have. I don't know. I've studied the rapture and taught seminars. I taught many seminars here in the Philippines on end times. And I've done revivals in churches in the States all over the place, teaching and preaching on end time events. And so I would say I know pretty much about this topic as much as most people, except for maybe a few high theologians. But but anyway, brothers and sisters, I've never seen this before. 1 Corinthians 15, 22, 23, 24, what we're looking at. And the whole chapter, this whole section on up through the end, of, as in verse 50, he's still talking about, behold, I show you, 51, I show you a mystery that we shall not sleep, but we shall be changed. In a moment, in a twinkling of an eye, the last trump, for the trump shall sound, and the dead shall raise incorruptible, and we shall be changed. For this corruptible must put on incorruption. It's the same text. That's what he's talking about through the whole thing. I'm going to cut this off, and I shall return with an awesome video the Lord gave me about the Sabbath versus Sunday. It's going to be awesome.